So I'm with Penny and the round pin. Penny hasn't been worked in quite some time. This is the first time she's had a saddle on in a while. Good girl, Penny. Penny's very responsive in the round pin. Good girl. I see so many people pointing in the direction of the way they want the horse to go, and it's really such a disservice because if you go in front of their tipping point, see, did you see me go to the left a little bit? That is her cue to turn to the right. So if you go in front of their tipping point, whether it be with a whip or an arm or whatever, you're telling them to do something. So it's like whenever you hold the lunge whip in your right hand and you want them to go to the left, that's essentially the same thing as you pointing that way. The whip is an extension of your arm. So if you're pointing one way and the whip's pointing the other, they get really confused really quickly as to what you want them to do. Good girl. So it's really important that you stay as quiet as you possibly can, and you keep your arms down. And if you want them to, if you need to point at something, it will be at their hip. Their hip drives the horse forward, not the nose. So you want to drive the horse forward from the hind end. That's why pointing really doesn't make a whole lot of sense. You want to drive them forward from their hind end and get that forward motion, that power going. Whenever you want to stop them, see me go to the left. I walked in front of her tipping point, no extended arms necessary. I'm sitting here with no whip. I'm just holding the phone, and she's watching my body movements to find out which way that I want for her to go. Very responsive mare. Good girl. And she's coming into me until I click at her. The click means I'd like for you to move away, please. Give me some forward motion. And so she goes, okay. And notice how calm she is. Because I'm not pointing, I don't have a whip, it's not necessary with her. She's already a more hot mare. She already has a lot of forward motion. So whenever you add any type of external stimulus, she's going to take that up another 5 notches. So it's just going to make her more anxious. It's just going to make her harder to work with. And cuz watch, see, that's all it takes to get her to move forward. That's it. And to get her to slow down, you just step in front of her tipping point. See? Good girl. Very nice. This is probably one of the sweetest mares I've ever seen. Now, she has a lot of energy. And I guarantee you, this mare will buck. So if you don't want to deal with that, or if you can't sit a buck, you don't want this mare. So I'm going to ride her in a few minutes, and I'll let you know what she remembers, what she knows, we'll go from there. She needs a very, very quiet rider. She's got a lot of buttons, I can guarantee it, with all that dressage training that she has. The last time I saddled her up, I'm pretty sure I put the jumping saddle on her, and she was not very happy. She bucked with that jumping saddle on. Notice this time I have the dressage saddle on her, and she feels much, much more comfortable, much calmer in this saddle. Such a good horse. Very sweet. Always the forward ears, always the happiness, licking, chewing. Of course, we're very quiet people. We work the horses in a really quiet way. So for a really nervous horse like this one, it does her a lot of good. Everybody asks me how I make them so calm. Well, that's it. We work them very quietly, and there's not much pressure. I don't like pressure. And so I avoid it like the plague. So that's how I treat my horses as well. Good girl, Penny. Oh, sweet, sweet horse. Very sweet horse. All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and hop on and we'll see how she does. Say bye, Penny.